Well, it's one for the money.
Hi, my name is Lawrence Blue Mitchell. I'm the co-owner of Royal Studios and engineer and producer. The most challenging thing about producing the Memphis Music Hall of Fame concert and award show is really scheduling, because we have a lot of artists that we, you know, try to get involved because we want to make it, you know, as authentic and representative of the inductees as we can, and just coordinating the special guests to come in, getting everybody's schedule and stuff, that is some kind of sometimes nightmarish, but we always manage to pull it off. We always try to make it where it's something for everybody. So, you know, whether you like folk music or blues music or pop music, we always try to get artists that'll be, you know, representative of the inductees, but, you know, still have a little, always try to put a little spin on things. Like, I got Bobby Rush to do Johnny Cash, because both of them had songs named Sue, so I thought that was cool. Some of my favorite performances, the first year I produced it, would definitely be Carla Thomas. She just really went out there and killed it. And apparently she did Gee Whiz, and apparently she hadn't sang that song in years. So Carla's performance, you know, was always a soft spot. The Bar K's that year too, just like came on stage and slayed everything. We weren't expecting that. Marques are always awesome, but they just really took it to the next level. so that was good. The two performances that stuck out to me last year, one was BJ Thomas, who was a complete surprise. I, you know, was always familiar with his work, but I've never seen him perform. And, you know, I really didn't know what to expect. And this guy went out there and just, man, he just tore the house down. You know, it was, I probably would have structured the show a little different if I'd have known he was going to be that awesome. It, you know, it means so much to our family to have our father, Willie Mitchell, inducted into the Hall of Fame. But, you know, for him to be in the first round, too, is a huge, such a huge honor, a blessing. You know, I was always, I guess, my dad's biggest cheerleader, or at least I thought I was. Just even growing up, I used to be like, man, how come, you know, he doesn't get the recognition that he deserves? And, you know, to finally have something like this is just a huge honor and blessing to the family. This Cashbox Award is cool because not only did I see that statue every day growing up as a kid, and I don't think I really knew what it was back then. I thought it was my dad. I thought it was like a picture of him, you know, a sculpture of him playing the trumpet. But the Cashbox Award is cool. When he won the Best Instrumentalist, him and Herb Alford from A&M Records, Herb Alford started A&M Records, but apparently him and Herb used to battle for this award every year. It would go to one or the other, and I had no idea. I think Herb Alford did a song with Janet Jackson, and I was a teenager, and I said something about it. I was like, yeah, Herb Alford, that's my partner, man. I'm like, you know Herb Alford? I didn't even know Herb Alford played the trumpet or anything until that point. So he was telling me about this award. So this makes it pretty cool. You know, when you do these shows with the caliber of people, just the house band, you know, the high rhythm section, having those guys involved with something like that just takes things to another level. And then a lot of these guest artists, they, you know, they want to perform with those guys. These are the guys they want to perform with, because these are the guys that, you know, played on all the hit Al Green and Peoples and Otis Clay records, you know. So it's kind of like performing with, you know, the Funk Brothers or, you know, the Muscle Shoals rhythm section. And it just takes everything to another level, and you really don't ever know what you're going to get when these guest artists start coming in. So it's always a surprise. You know, something happens. There's always this energy that comes from out of nowhere that just blows everybody away. Like the Barquets 1 year, and then B.J. Thomas the next year. It's just, you never know what you're going to get. And it's always awesome. It's always epic.